But fortunately, our story doesn't end there, and the future looks promising for the management of NAFLD NASH patients. As we've alluded to through this video, cirrhosis, which is a stage 4 fibrosis, is the main hard outcome that we want to avoid for our patients. Ballooning and inflammation are believed to be the two key drivers of NASH activity, and NASH is the underlying cause of non-alcoholic, non-viral fibrosis. This means that treating NASH effectively may prevent NASH-induced cirrhosis, and that with the resolution of ballooning and inflammation, NASH will resolve. For this reason, the FDA and the EMA have agreed that this is the recommended endpoint for registration trials for new drug development in NASH. So how do we achieve these goals? Remember that the development of NASH starts with liver insults resulting from insulin resistance and other metabolic factors. However, the transformation from steatosis to NASH is a complex process driven by multiple mechanisms involving a myriad of extrinsic and intrinsic pathways. So it stands to reason that no single therapy is likely to resolve NASH. The corollary is that therapies that affect multiple pathways are highly desirable for this condition. This is different from the situation with HCV, where we are now able to cure 99% of patients. However, our knowledge of NASH therapies is similar to where we were with HCV over a decade ago. And even though we are in the early process of drug development, over 20 different drugs are under various stages of investigation for NASH, and two of these agents are even in phase 3 programs, meaning the latest stage before market approval. Their potential is recognized by regulatory agencies, including the FDA and the EMA, which have allowed these programs to be conducted under an accelerated approval process. One of these two leading drugs is elafibranor, a dual agonist of PPAR-alpha and delta that addresses NASH through multiple pathways. As mentioned earlier, affecting multiple pathways is an important aspect of any NASH drug, given the multifaceted profile of the disease. As stated by the AASLD and the FDA, it is crucial, and for those already at high risk of cardiovascular disease, it is certainly mandatory to be able to control LDL, HDL, and triglyceride levels. The same is true for insulin resistance-related parameters, such as HOMA-IR or HbA1c. Last but not least, the silent nature of NASH means that drug therapy must be well tolerated by patients. Indeed, patients who may not feel sick may be tempted to stop therapy if treatment is not well tolerated. This may also be an issue for access, as payers may be less likely to reimburse drugs that patients are unlikely to tolerate.
Diabetes, high cholesterol, obesity, having any of these conditions increases the risk for NASH. Preventing and treating NASH, the underlying cause of fibrosis, is vital to stopping progression to cirrhosis. Recognizing fatty liver disease in your own clinical practice and keeping up with the latest advances and research opportunities in your area will all help to address this critical unmet need.